and concern tonight over cases in Immokalee, and some residents are now questioning, should the community have stayed in phase one, where we were May 18th when restaurants and retailers operated at only 50% capacity? Business owners tell NBC2's Jennifer Vegas, though, going back to limited customers will cripple them for years to come.
Well, what you see behind me is a farmer's market out here in Immokalee. It looks like a ghost town because many farm workers have moved up north for the next harvest season. Now residents like Danny Gonzalez, the owner of this Mexican restaurant, are left wondering what's next.
This COVID really took a toll in everybody. I'm not going to say just me. It took in everybody here locally. And this past year has been, for the past 3 months, it's been like, we just making it.
Barren tables and an anxious wait staff. That's what Lozano's restaurant looks like today.
Now what you see here is the residents. The residents that are work here year round.
But he says in March, during phase one and peak season, farm workers would flood his restaurant. But with farm workers moving elsewhere onto the next harvest season, he's confused why cases continue to rise in the Immokalee community. Gloria Padilla, vice chair of the Immokalee Unmet Needs Coalition, says something needs to change in Immokalee, suggesting adding an extra 14 days to self-isolation in Immokalee.
I feel like as a resident of Immokalee, I'm very wary about going out in the community and seeing this. I really would have preferred that we at least extend no opening, stay in phase one until the 14 days.
Though he's closing for the month of July, he says that would make the summer even harder for businesses like his.
You're going to hurt the people that are here. They're going to get hurt more. And by the time you know it, this will be a ghost town.
We reached out to state and local leaders to see if this is even a possibility for one community, but we have not heard back yet. I'm live in Immokalee, Jennifer Beglis, NBC2.